church and the card machine. If you're watching us online, then the links are in the notes below both of the posts. This Thursday evening, it sees the start of our new virtual start course. And it's going to be posted every Thursday evening, and it runs for about 6 weeks. Each week will stay online, so you don't have to watch it on the Thursday evening. You can watch it whenever you want to, because we're not going to take them down. The Start course is designed for people who are exploring faith, although it's good for all of us, but it's primarily designed for people who have been engaging with us online during lockdown and are maybe sort of exploring the beginning of their faith. So please, if you are on Facebook, take that and repost it onto your page so that we can get it shared as widely as possible. And please do pray for the Start course as we go through the next few weeks. So we're just going to still ourselves as we come before the Lord this morning in worship. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you, and also with you. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. And so we pray together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our first hymn this morning is Love Divine, and please remember that we have to watch the hymns and not sing them. This is Love Divine.
Thank you.
light the things now hidden in darkness, and will disclose the purposes of the heart. Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us confess our sins. And so we pray. Lord God, we have sinned against you. We have done evil in your sight. We are sorry and repent. Have mercy on us according to your love. Wash away our wrongdoing and cleanse us from our sin. Renew a right spirit within us and restore us to the joy of your salvation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so may the Lord enrich you with his grace and nourish you with his blessing. May the Lord defend you in trouble and keep you from all evil. May the Lord accept your prayers and absolve you from your offences, for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. Our reading today is taken from the Gospel of Matthew. It's chapter 14, and we begin to read at verse 13. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Now when Jesus heard this, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion on them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came and said to him, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is very late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages to buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." They replied, "We have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. And all ate and were filled. And they took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. So may I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. At the very beginning of this reading, the first thing that it says is "now when Jesus heard this." So we actually need to find out what it was that he heard. So we need to find out what happened immediately before the feeding of the 5,000. You see, what had actually just happened was that King Herod had just had John the Baptist, Jesus' cousin, beheaded. Herod had been holding a big feast for his birthday, and his daughter had danced for him and she pleased him. So he rather rashly told her that he would give her anything that she wanted. And she, prompted by her mum, asked for the head of John the Baptist. And because Herod had publicly said that she could have anything that she wanted, he felt that he could not go back on his promise, so he had John the Baptist beheaded. And at the beginning of this reading, Jesus has just received the news that Herod has killed his cousin. And so Jesus decides to get away. Now, we're not entirely sure whether Jesus needs to go away to mourn in private, or whether he's running away from Herod because he's frightened that Herod is going to do the same to Jesus. Or maybe it's a mixture of the both. But either way, Jesus withdraws. He moves out of public sight. We often hear in the Gospel, Gospels how Jesus takes himself out of a situation and he withdraws to a place of quiet and a place of privacy. We hear that he takes himself off up a mountain to pray or across a lake. And this is a theme that we frequently see during his ministry. And then often, if you read the Gospels, it's following a time of solace, a time of quiet, a time of prayer, that the biggest of Jesus' miracles occur. Of course, the irony in this situation is that the crowds follow Jesus. He's trying to get away, to get some peace and quiet, and the thousands of people, they follow him. I think if you're a parent of young children, you probably get this feeling, don't you? You're just desperate to get away and get a little bit of peace and quiet, and the kids won't let you. It's a little bit like that. However, we read that Jesus got into a boat, and he would have sailed across the Sea of Galilee, and actually the journey across the sea would have taken a little bit of time. So whilst Jesus was expecting to travel to a place of solitude, actually the journey would have been in his solitude, because whilst he was in the boat, he would have had downtime and quiet time and time to sleep and time to rest. Rest sometimes comes in strange places. I guess a lot of us have just had several weeks of enforced rest, haven't we? And of course, there are some people who have had absolutely no rest for the last few weeks. But rest is incredibly productive. Now, I know that does sound like a little bit of a contradiction, but if we want to be productive for God, in fact, actually, if we want to be productive in any area of our life, then periods of rest are essential. We need to rest our bodies and our minds in order for them to be able to run the race that God has set out for us in advance. As you know, my Paul is a triathlete, and one of the things that he will tell you is that whilst he has to train really hard, the rest days, i.e. the days when he doesn't train, are as vital to his performance in a race. You see, rest days ensure that the muscles and the heart and the lungs, they physically recoup. And it's during the periods of rest that the muscles grow. It's not during the periods of exercise that the muscles grow. So all athletes will tell you that if you train constantly, you will do worse in a race. But if you have a day off, a day where you don't train, you will do better in your final race. Bizarrely, rest makes the body fitter. And the same is true for all of us in all areas of our life. Regular periods of rest are vital to ensure that we are equipped and ready to work for Christ all the rest of the time. I know that for some people, rest over the past few weeks has been virtually impossible. My best friend has been working at the hospital, and we spent some time together on Friday, and as we were talking, she kept sort of nodding and falling asleep, and in the end I told her to just lie down and go to sleep for half an hour, because she was just so totally exhausted. We cannot carry on, and we cannot continue in our life when we are totally exhausted. And so we have to take those opportunities to take the rest when they are given to us. Have you ever sat down to pray at the end of the day and fallen asleep? Yeah, do you know I've done that? In fact, I do it quite often. And I used to get really cross with myself when this happened. Oh gosh, you know, I've been a really bad Christian. I can't even stay awake long, to pray. You know, it's ridiculous. And actually, sometimes when we pray, God doesn't need to hear the words. He just gives us rest, because that's what we need. And so sometimes, when I fall asleep in the middle of prayer, I just go, okay, this is God's way of saying, I've taken all of your prayers and I know all of that stuff. I'm giving you right now what you need, and this is some rest. Go to bed. But there is one other thing rest that Jesus took, and that is that he spent his rest time with his heavenly Father. You see, Jesus took the opportunity of the downtime to reconnect in prayer with his Father. By removing the distractions of everyday living, he was able to relax in the presence of God, to abide with him, to listen to him, to learn what it was that God wanted him to focus on next. What was his next job? What was his next challenge? I said earlier on that Jesus' biggest miracles in the Gospels are preceded directly by a time of rest. There's no coincidence in that. Jesus rested in God and sat with his Heavenly Father and listened to him during those periods of rest. And then when he was recovered, he went out and achieved some awesome things for God. Periods of rest are essential. But of course, we never rest from being a child of God. Rest doesn't mean we abandon our faith or our regular prayer time. We should rest instead with the Lord. Amen. So we're going to stand to declare our faith in the words of the Creed. Would you please stand? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. So would you please be seated for our prayers of intercession. Our prayers have been written by Anne Crowther. Luke chapter 4. Jesus said, "The Spirit of the Lord is on me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." Lord Jesus, we need you to bring wisdom, compassion, and healing to our country and around the world. We can do nothing in our own strength, only in yours. Lord, we pray locally for the city of Blackburn and Greater Manchester and surrounding areas in further lockdown with a high rise in the virus infection rate. May the people there come through this time of trial with your help, O Lord. We pray that the spread of the virus will stop in this country, in Europe, and around the world. And we pray for those countries who are experiencing a spike in infections once more, especially America and Spain. Father, we pray that you would bring healing to those struggling in hospitals and care homes, and protection for those who are tending them. And we pray especially today for our Muslim brothers and sisters planning to celebrate Eid, for whom the lockdown is especially difficult. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who are destitute in other countries without the level of health care that we have here in the UK, and especially the children who are left on the streets to fend for themselves. We pray for those in this country who are trying to shelter in doorways when the weather is bad because they have nowhere else to stay. We pray for those with addictions and mental health problems, that they will be treated with understanding and respect and not be forgotten. And Lord, we ask that you would protect those in dangerous situations, even in their own homes. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for a revival of faith over this whole area. Oh dear Lord, we are asking for miracles in small things and in huge things, for nothing is impossible with you. Help us to be your hands and feet on the earth. Work in us, Holy Spirit. We pray for all those who have lost loved ones in the crisis and for other reasons. May they know that God understands their grief and shares it with them. And we also pray for those who are struggling with illness of any kind. May they know your peace today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And yet the time is coming when Christ Jesus will call his people, young and old, children and grandparents, to lift the banner of victory. So may the God of hope fill you all with joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. So may God the Father, judge all merciful, make us worthy of a place in his kingdom. Amen. May God the Son, coming in us in power, reveal in our midst the promise of his glory. Amen. May God the Holy Spirit make us steadfast in faith, joyful in hope, and constant in love. Amen. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Our final hymn is Great is the Lord.
Thank you.
Well, thank you everybody for coming along today to join us either in person for worship or virtually. The live stream is down for about 3 or 4 minutes, so we will repost the whole service because we have recorded it later on in the day, so you can watch it then if you missed a little bit in the middle. So go in peace to